There's the little sneak. That's him in the back, Cole.
That cherry pie was delicious.
Buddy.
You're looking good.
You're gonna help me, right?
That's what I'm here for.
You got the money?
The 20? Sure, right here.
20? I said...
You want the money or the alternative?
Tell us about the reefer, Freddy.
Who's he?
Another good Samaritan. Answer the question.
Grass comes from Tijuana. They bring in 50 pounds a week.
50 pounds? Are you hallucinating, Freddy?
It's stashed at a house at 1452 North Las Palmas.
Names, Freddy.
The guy at the house is a spick that goes by the name Juan Garcia Cruz. Well, be careful. He likes guns. Or do I get my money?
Do me a favor, Freddy. Spend the money on a bus ticket. You can't last forever on a snitch jacket.
Oh, sister.
Let's go visit this Cruz character. 50 pounds of dope. Crazy. Believe a story? Sure. A hophead like Freddy would raffle his sister for his next score.
Any in the vicinity of Austin needs assistance. 1825 North Highland Avenue, 1825 North Highland Avenue.
Detective Phelps, I got the call for assistance. Who were the suspects?
Bank robbers. Same gang that took the Citizens National Trust and Savings last month.
That's all of them. You're behind the wheel.
Thank you.
3.
Reinforcements are on the way. Cease and desist.
Politely to move on. Next time I won't be so nice.
You guys don't have to leave a mess. What happened?
Dope peddler, Juan Cruz. He opened fire and, well, the rest of the story tells itself.
Juan Garcia Cruz. This is his address, but this place looks like a front. A silver dollar. I thought they took these things out of circulation. These are the guys keeping Juan so well stocked with soup.
Doesn't anyone eat regular meals anymore? Junkies feeding on popcorn and grasshoppers living on soup.
Doesn't tell me anything. Probably nothing. Is this a drug or a village in Borneo? Doesn't appear to be in Spanish.
That's what I think. I've seen it all.
This doesn't pertain to the case.
You jump like a girl.
Now we're getting somewhere.
More soup?
Who in the hell keeps a secret stash of soup?
You hungry or something, Phelps?
I'd say that's pretty good value for 12 cents.
Factory sealed. Someone at the cannery has a lot of explaining to do.
With Juan dead, we need a new suspect, Cole. Is there a pattern to the deliveries?
This guy EJ seems to be bringing in most of the serious weight. Dates and times seem pretty regular. We should notify the border crossing.
Those fuckers are probably in on it. Let's wait and see how this plays out.
Brother says the morphine is still turning up.
Makes sense. We have no idea how much of the stuff Lenny shifted. There's been no comeback from Cohen.
And the Confidential magazine is right, and Bugsy is on the slide.
You read that stuff? I wouldn't say it to his face if I was you. That is one hot-tempered son of a bitch.
Whatever you're carrying, hand it over. I'd say he's got about half a can left. I guess that makes me a pessimist.
You can't take me in.
Take you in? Be glad he didn't shoot you. I wouldn't have chased you. If it was up to me, you'd be talking out of a hole in the back of your head.
I want information.
Señor, I would like to help you. But I got a family in Mexico I have to provide for. And my compadres are very unreasonable.
Your compadres? Turn out your pockets. I need Ray to run down these silver dollars.
I need to make a deal. I need guarantees.
You have identification? Sanchez Erto, Mexican, Tijuana address. Here's the deal, Erto. You give me information, and I won't give you to immigration. Give me EJ, the driver bringing in the shipments, or I'll make you for it.
I run the shop. That's all I do.
Start talking, Erto. I want the names of everyone involved.
What difference does it make what I tell you? I'm still going to jail, no?
Tell me about the soup cans.
The soup is very popular, as you can see.
I think you're the connection on the Mexican side. I think you're more than you like to make out.
So now I'm the big man in this? I have big dreams. I want to make enough to bring my family over. Don't stand in my way, policeman.
You're going to jail, Erto. Our jails may be nicer than what you could expect in Mexico, but I can tie you up in red tape for years.
Service of the American Century Broadcasting System. Some swell harmony right here.
can't see these people, right?
Can you drive to this one?
Right. Let's see if we can find out who's been overseasoning the soup in this place.
LAPD. Who owns this factory, ma'am?
Mr. Parnell, Howard Parnell, I'll let him know you're here. Please, take a seat.
If you don't mind, we'll come with you.
If you must.
You just wanted a follower, didn't you? You sly dog. I must apologize for my partner's roving eye. He hates saying goodbye, but he loves watching them leave.
Give it a rest, Roy.
If you could show these men in to see Mr. Parnell, Doris. They're from the LAPD.
Follow me, gentlemen.
What is going on? We're a family company using family recipes. We don't know anything about dope rings. I need you to stop this from ruining the company's reputation.
LAPD, sit tight, fatso. You could be in very serious trouble.
There's no reason to be rude. Take a seat, gentlemen. I'm sure we can sort this all out.
Maybe you can explain why we found $5 bags of marijuana in sealed Parnell soup cans.
That's an outrageous allegation.
How do you explain it, Chubby? We found at least 30 cans, all sealed up tight with your label on them.
Can I get a list of your employees?
Of course. We have nothing to hide. Doris? Can you bring me in the current employee listing?
Here it is, Mr. Parnell.
On the desk, please.
Any name on that list that rings a bell?
This is familiar. 1452 North Las Palmas. A Jorge Garcia Cruz. The factory sealed cans we found suggest a very professional operation, Mr. Parnell. We're looking for an inside man.
I know nothing about this. I want this stopped as much as you do.
You must suspect someone, Mr. Parnell.
Are you sure it isn't someone who stole some of my labels? That would be pretty easy to do.
How are your sales, Mr. Parnell?
Just fine and dandy, son. We're entering a new era of prosperity. I hope you're both big soup eaters.
You're being economical with the truth, Parnell. You, can't keep the business afloat, so you've turned to dope.
Would you like to prove that I'm involved in this scam? I'm a legitimate businessman.
Sorry. Sometimes you have to shake the tree to see what falls out.
Mr. Parnell, do you know what kind of trouble you're in? Come clean with us.
Okay, so things are a little flat. We're deciding whether to lower production. It's taken a while to adjust to not having any military contracts. You know, we sold Uncle Sam 5 million cans of minestrone.
Ever heard of Juan Garcia Cruz?
Not that I know of.
He has a brother employed here. You know him?
We employ large numbers of Mexicans. I'm not familiar with them all.
That's funny, Parnell. He has the same address as his brother Juan, who we shot dead less than an hour ago. You better give me something.
Look, I'm not involved in this. I'm getting enough grief from Washington. There's an investigation going on into profiteering. Like a guy shouldn't be able to turn a buck while the war is on?
I'm sure thousands of dead Marines sleep soundly knowing that you did okay. Tell us about Jorge Garcia Cruz.
Jorge? I had no idea of his last name. His team does daily maintenance on the conveyor belts and cookers.
You're being made a patsy by a dope ring, Parnell, and you're happy to sit here and let it happen.
You want my help? I said I'd help. You want to call me names? You can go fuck yourself.
We'd like to take a look around the factory floor, Mr. Parnell.
I hope we won't have to shut down the line.
No, nothing like that.
Thank you. I'm grateful for that. I'll show you around myself.
I hate seeing how things are made. This is gonna be like that time I went to the slaughterhouse and couldn't eat steak for a week.
This is where the produce comes in. We peel and sort all of the vegetables and add them to the line in regular quantities.
Fascinating.
Why don't you keep quiet? I've learned something.
Oh, good God. This really is turning into some nightmare school trip flashback.
This is the hopper, which boils and purees the vegetables. The other hopper is for the pasta. This way, please.
You're loving this, aren't you, Phelps?
The soup is ladled automatically into cans. Next stage is labeling.
I'd like to see the packing and dispatch area, if you don't mind.
Sure. It's over here. Follow me.
Wow. That sure looks like a beauty.
This is one of our dispatchers. Sergio, right?
Yes, sir.
These men are from the LAPD. Sergio here records our outgoing deliveries. They all go in the book. Just there on the desk.
We're looking for repeat business in large amounts, Cole.
What's going on, Parnell? There's enough soup going to this place every day to feed a company of Marines.
What are you talking about?
I'd like a private word with your dispatcher, if you don't mind.
Sure, go right ahead. I'll be over here when you need me.
Can I have a look at that coin?
Sure, why not?
Silver dollar, right?
Yeah, that's right.
The markings on it say it's been taken out of circulation.
Maybe. I'm not trying to buy anything with it. I like it. It brings me luck.
Do you have access to the canning area?
I do. But I keep to my station. Loading and unloading. Don't care much for soup.
Sergio, if you don't give me something, I'm gonna go to Immigration Services and have you deported.
I get a shipment once every 2 weeks. Ernesto does the driving. I don't know his full name. It's delivered here at night, or he gets it canned up. From here, it gets sent all over the country.
What do you know about the 20th century market?
Nada. I get the orders from upstairs. I send the goods where I'm told.
And you don't know Juan Garcia Cruz?
No, not me.
You're a liar, Sergio. You're in it, and I'm gonna break you for it.
You're loco, Placa. I got nothing to do with Juan Garcia.
Matching silver dollar on Juan Garcia. What are the odds of that, Sergio?
Juan and Jorge are brothers. They're cousins. They work for some evil gabacho. The guy is an aberration. He gives out the silver dollars. Jorge gets me a list of deliveries every morning. 20th century is always on.
You keep your mouth shut for today and I'll take you in. Do we have a deal?
Do I have a choice?
Is that a serious question? That's it for now, Sergio. If we need to speak to you again, we'll put in a call to Mr. Parnell.
If you have to, I guess.
We will be in touch, Mr. Parnell. Freddie said they were moving 50 pounds a week. That's a lot of soup cans.
I think this is an interstate operation. Moving dope around the country to selected grasshoppers. Local weed gets distributed in the usual way, through Pachuco street punks.
Someone must know something about this drug baron character.
Here they come. Let him unload the goods first.
Now?
Let's get him. All right, move. Move! Let's go!
Everyone into position.
Got your back.
LAPD, put your hands where we can see them.
Okay, gentlemen, we'll take the lead. You cover us. Go, Pat. Get in there.
Everyone into position.
Perimeter is up. The whole place is contained.
LAPD, put your hands where we can see them.
Go, pal. Get in there.
Throw it.
Detectives, found something here you probably want to see.
Tijuana address. We should see what the federales have on it. $1 per dead man. Doesn't seem like much for a human life.
God damn. I think we found our stash, Cole. Take a look in these boxes.
Minimum another 50 pounds.
Detectives, I think we got the guy. Does the name Cruz mean something to you?
It certainly does.
Mm-hmm.
yet another silver dollar. Must be $1,000 here.
Phelps, Earl, looks like quite a bloodbath. What was this all about?
Drugs and money. What else? Speaking of money, where did that roll go?
I picked it up for safekeeping. The department owes me 50.
Ray, I have another 2 coins for you.
Great. I've got something to show you. It's all set up on the table over here. There. Take a look at these coins you've been collecting.
There are letters cut into each coin, along with not legal tender. What does it mean?
Those are Morgan silver dollars from the 20s. They were removed from circulation and sent for disposal. A number of smelters around the country had the contract. Look at them together. Can you work out what it says?
First coin, MAS. The second, ANG. The third, KAY. The fourth, MET. The fifth, ALS. Mesanke Metals.
A metal foundry. Would you like the address?
Would I ever?
1034 Vine Street, Hollywood. We'll finish up here. It's already been a long night, Phelps. See if you can talk them into giving themselves up.
You know the way. You can drive.
Where are we going?
I'll tell you when I see what's waiting for us at the top.
Weapons on the ground, now!
Victor Sanders.
You know this guy?
I should have known.
Of course I know Roy. Roy and I have had an arrangement for many years.
You're under arrest.
Am I?
We have a mountain of prima facie evidence, as well as the testimony.
You'd be surprised how things have a habit of sorting themselves out. Evidence disappearing. Witnesses that can't be found. Policemen that forget. The impossible becomes probable when you have a client list like mine.
Shut your mouth! Turn around and put your hands behind your back.
Working vice can be a thankless task, Phelps. But on behalf of the brass and the moms and dads and the concerned citizens, I'd like to commend you and your partner for smashing this dope ring. Reefer is almost as big a threat to the children of this city as communism.
What about Sanders, Lieutenant?
Leave Sanders to me, Phelps. The chief will be looking after that one personally.
He will be brought to trial.
Phelps, we are celebrating your success. Don't push your luck. Sanders is no longer your problem.
Your platoon is what remains of recon. I'm folding you into the 22nd. You'll be going up that damn hill tonight.
We're intelligence gathering, sir.
I don't need intelligence, son. I need men who can hold rifles and kill Japs. Tonight, you're a rifle company. We've got cooks, mechanics, and stretcher bearers all going into the line. We aim to break them tonight, Lieutenant.
Good to see you, Hank.
You too, Cole. How's your war?
Not quite what I expected.
As long as I live, I will never get over that sound.
Hey, who's that medic? He'll be killed going out there.
It's Sheldon, the guy from the Asakawa Bridge. That guy's got no fear.
He didn't make it.
I didn't go out there to save him.
What are you saying, man?
I went out there to put him out of his misery, to ease his pain. Do you have a problem with that?
Murder, Corman.
That's war, Lieutenant. Smell the stench. Feel the whore's breath on your neck.
You need help, man.
Call for me tonight, Lieutenant. When you're up on that hill. I've been up there 3 times already. The circles of hell have nothing on Sugarloaf Hill.
Get this madman out of my sight! Phelps. I did a little boxing in the Marines. I found it a pretty humbling experience.
Fix you a sandwich, buddy. Corned beef and egg salad, 12 cents. Bologna and ham and cheese, 10.
It's strictly a mug's game. You'll like this fight, though. A plucky limey's about to take a beating from an up-and-coming Negro.
You sound pretty sure about the result.
I ought to be. I got 50 bucks on the black kid. Let's get a ringside seat. Thank you. That son of a bitch Hammond made a run for his dressing room. Let's find out what's going on. God damn you, Abbott! You get out here right now!
Step back! LAPD!